Well, hello there, and welcome to my podcast. I'm Janine. This is Quest for You. I record episodes Monday through Friday for you to have something inspirational for the week. Yes, it's a ton of work. Trust me, all my friends have told me, stop doing it. Too many episodes. But what can you do? I enjoy it, and I also want to create value for you. I want to help you, and I find nothing more helpful than a consistent daily reminder of what it takes to be just a little bit better, some encouragement, knowing that someone has gone through something similar and it's there for you. And this is the person I would like to be, and that's why I'm here 5 days a week. If you know of someone that needs somebody like this, then just please pass my message on. And today, in episode 169, we're going to talk about the things that are not right, yet we still do them anyway. And I know there are those things that you're doing that you know that are wrong. Every time you do them, you know that you should stop. Yet, you do it anyway. Not just you, but all of us. We all have good, solid reasons why we do them. We made a conscious decision to do these things. So these are not the snap judgments we make about others, or the angry outbursts we cannot seem to control, or the negative thoughts that creep up when we're really depressed. We know these are wrong, but we don't consciously plan these. They are reactions, impulses, some wrong wiring that will take time to fix. But there are innumerable other, smaller things that we do on a daily basis that we have rationalized as being okay, even though they're not. Maybe you're not wearing your seatbelt. You're telling smart little lies to keep the peace. Or maybe you're helping yourself to office supplies at work that end up at home. You cut people off in traffic. You don't put enough money in the parking meter. You consistently arrive late. You drink or eat too much on weekends. And you spend way too much on Amazon. I could go on. These are bad habits. And the problem with bad habits is that we eventually define ourselves by them. They start as a small breach. Let's test and see how it goes. And since there often is not a negative consequence, we continue. And it becomes a pattern. And such a pattern can even lead to a sense of entitlement. And that is when we allow it to define our identity. I just don't wear seatbelts. They are too constricting. I am really good at telling small lies. I can get away with it. I am not punctual. I just don't have it in me. Always running a few minutes late. I'm a social drinker. And so forth. See how small actions can come to define us? They become part of our perceived persona of who we believe we are. So I want you to let this sink in for a second and imagine a loop. One small, bad behavior. A few more, a pattern, and a pattern becomes a habit, and habit turns into our identity. Now think of the power you have at your fingertips with the decision to stop this loop. You can cut the bad loop off by simply deciding to end the behavior. And by doing so, it will then also end your identification with that pattern. So if I asked you about those things you do that are not in your best interest, what would come to mind? I realize you may think of something major right now. It's our tendency, right? I work too much. I eat out many times. I overspend on clothes. Whatever comes to mind. But start this by focusing on something you can stop doing almost immediately. Something small. Maybe you drive in the HOV lane during a certain stretch on your morning commute. You could simply decide today not to do it. There are no major behavioral shifts required. You don't need to prepare or meditate over it or plan some kind of an alternative action. You simply don't turn into the HOV lane this morning. What would happen? Well, let me tell you what will happen. Initially, there will be some discomfort. Maybe even a small battle with yourself. I will be late to work. I'm the only stupid one following the rules. Everyone in that lane is passing me and laughing at me because I am stuck in traffic. You see, we are reversing the bad habit loop here. Initially, you felt bad because you engaged in something wrong. Now you feel bad trying to reverse to the good. What you're feeling is the letting go of something that was comfortable and easy. And while you know it was wrong, it's still pulling you a little with its appeal. But you can do it. That's why we start with something small. Minor things will not have such a strong pull. You can quit them almost instantly. Now, did something come to mind for you? You see, many of my podcast episodes focus on action. What can you do that will change your life? But today is much easier. Imagine yourself not doing some of the things anymore that you know are wrong. Wrong because they're unsafe, maybe because they break a law, or wrong for you because they negatively affect your life. Today, all you need is to decide on something you will not do anymore. The action is already there, but it's not the right one or it needs some tweaking. So all you need to do is stop doing it. And when you do that, you will discover something beautiful. Yeah, maybe at first it's a little bit hard, a little bit uncomfortable. But after a while, you will identify with the new, the good habit. The loop is reversed. You'll sit in traffic and you'll look at the people illegally driving in the carpool lane. Not with envy, but with pity. Knowing that it's wrong. Knowing that the fine they could get is hefty. And feeling good about yourself being good. A new habit forms. And a new identity shapes up. And sooner than later, you will see something else you could also stop doing. Maybe this time it's a more challenging part of your life. By stopping something, even if it's easy, it strengthens you. It builds character and willpower. It creates habits that are easier to maintain. Less energy wasted on feeling guilty, shameful, and worried. And slowly, you get comfortable with being good. And this identity is much more rewarding than the bad one. And slowly and continually, you will move away from what is untrue and bad into a general direction of true and better. The bigger problems and challenges slowly become easier to tackle when you focus on the smaller ones first. You've practiced, and now you know how good it feels. So, I want to end this with a poem from Shel Silverstein that is perfect for our episode today. I asked the zebra, "Are you black with white stripes? Are you white with black stripes?" And the zebra asked me, "Are you good with bad habits? Are you bad with good habits? Are you noisy with quiet times? Are you quiet with noisy times? Are you happy with some sad days? Or are you sad with some happy days? Are you neat with some sloppy ways? Or are you sloppy with some neat ways?" And on and on and on and on and on he went. I'll never ask a zebra about stripes again. Much love, my friends, and I'll talk to you soon.